So you see one thing here, you can write in a triangle form, which is more rather useful to get the idea or remember the things. So P cross A. So if you want to measure force, then you cover force, which is equal to P cross A. If you want to find P, then F by A. And if you want to find A, F by P. Now, you see that force you can manipulate. Machine, what machine does? Class 6 and 7, you know. Machine is not a work multiplier, because it won't give you more work, rather it will give you less work, because some energy you have to give. Machine is not creator of, because you remember the energy conservation law, energy neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be transformed. Now, from one form to another form, and it can be transformed, and that transformation done by a device, and that's the device. So you have to give input energy, and you will get output energy as a work, your useful work, and then some waste of energy, which you can minimize, but you can't make it a zero. That means as much energy you are giving to work that machine. Machine is actually a dead body. By getting input energy, it is giving you output work and useful work, which you need to, like a bulb. Bulb, you need to have light. So it's a device where input is electrical energy, and then bulb giving you light, which is light energy, your useful energy. But of course, by this process, converting one form to another, you are getting your purpose served, and that is the purpose of a machine. And of course, it will waste by means of that transformation to some extent, which you can minimize but can't make it a zero. And that is, in case of bulb, is a heat and so on and so forth, which is not useful. But in case of immersion rod, heat is useful, whereas not light. Like a room heater, some heater having a reflector where the light is glowing, also emitting infrared, which is part of heat, but the visible part, red glowing, is a loss of energy. That's not producing any heat. So glowing heater is useful for the heat energy, but not the light energy. Light is the waste energy. Whereas for a bulb, light is useful, heat is waste. So by machine principle, by machine is nothing but converting one form of energy another form, which is your useful form. By doing so, it is losing some energy, but of course giving you some. But so it's not actually multiplier of work, not giving you less energy, more work, that means more energy. How then that excess energy produced? That means you create it, machine cannot create. And nobody can create. That's the basic thumb rule of energy. Now, what I'm trying to say, but it's a force multiplier. And that is why machine is doing work faster for us and easier. That's the basic definition of a machine. It's a combination. Complex machine is a combination. Lever is a simple machine which is making our work faster by multiplying force, and then making our work faster and less effort. But so this is, so if you can manipulate area, then you can manipulate force. And that is the hydraulic machine in case of fluid or say water. This is my syringe hydraulic. You see that I generally having another with the two same diameter, one 10 millimeter syringe, one is 2 millimeter syringe. You can have, I generally having insulin. Insulin syringe is further smaller. As much area difference you will make, you will get more advantage. So if you see, if you press this way, then of course you can't see, you are not here with me. But if you feel like what I'm, you just believe me, that if I press this way from the plunger, which is having more area, I feel more difficulty for this, from this side to press it up. Whereas if I do this way, it is very easy to push that other side back. That means if I do this with a smaller area, but pressure within remains same, But when it is going over the larger area, then the pressure multiplied by area force become more. That means if I keep some weight on top of this, say 10 kilogram, by 1 kilogram or 10 newton force, I can lift 10 kilogram, which is 100 newton weight. That means I am getting advantage by multiplying force from input side to output, and that is why it is a force multiplier, and mechanical advantage of this simple hydraulic is a 10, because load by effort is 110 newton, and if I say this is 10 times this, and that depends on the area ratio. If it is 10 times than this side, not difference ratio, if it is 10 times bigger area than the smaller side, then with a 1/10 of force I can lift the 10 times weight. And that, but one thing, it is lifting 10 times weight, so it will go 1/10 distance than this side, and that is how work remains same if not there is any loss. So it's not multiplying work, because you see, when I'm pressing this way, it is going more distance than this side, because it has more volume, it has less cross section, so more length to keep the same volume. Water is not compressing, so to keep the same volume of water going from right to left, it has to go more distance because cross section is less. It is a cylinder. Distance times cross section is the volume. And that is why it is traveling more distance. Whereas the, so if you see, if you go to any petrol pump station, when there is a car for wash and car need to be lifted up, so the person who is pressing hydraulic is doing a lot of hand moving, whereas car is moving up slowly. Because that side load is more, so it should go less distance. But this side load, effort is less, so it need to move more, so that the work from input and output will remain same. What does it mean? Now I can't convert with the machine more work with the less supplied energy or less work. Rather, I will get less work, some energy is lost. But with a less effort, I can keep it for a long time. That's why I can have 1 newton, I can press it for a long time, but I can't lift the whole car so heavy for a 1 centimeter height, because I'm not that strong, so I need to multiply force, and that's the machine. So liquid machine hydraulic is a kind of, this is a syringe hydraulic. So this is more or less at this moment for you all, having all related with force and pressure. But before I'll just switch over to another part, I'll show you one thing. Because of the gravity, you know, everything is falling down. Because down, Jack and Jill went up the hill, then who drops rolls down on the hill, foothill, so that you know. So that when you just climb a tree, who comes down from tree or going up, and whatever apple story of Newton is whether right or wrong, true or false, but it always comes down. But so you see the duster is coming down, but here you see that if you go to main museum, that every garden more or less having this same experiment, but this is a miniature form. This is a two ruler with a end is fixed with a simple black tape so that you can make it triangle track, and this is one small wooden platform so that you can keep wider part of this. Now I am actually telling you that the arrangement of this experiment, which I am not supposed to in case of offline teaching, because your observation. But I am just telling you to explain the setup. You have to track, which is a triangular track with a simple 1 foot ruler. But 1 meter ruler could have been much, visibility, or the experiment will continue for a long time. This is actually height. So this side is higher than this side. Now there are two funnels, simple, you just cut the notch so that it will be smooth, and you fix it, fix up with the glue. So there is nothing inside this funnel, right? But you need to have two funnels, like stuff, conical shape things. Now if I, you definitely know this height is lower than this side. But so what do you expect if I just leave this? Probably you all know the answer because many of you visit Science Museum and their garden everywhere. This is there. This is a simple miniature. I make it small so that I can carry it within my bag. My experiments, everything is actually in a miniature form so that I can carry even within this bag for my easy travel. And that's why this is called no cost, low cost experiment. I can't say this is no cost, but science doesn't require actually much of huge laboratory to build up to learn science. Rather, by picking up stuff from the ground, only thing you need to keep the hygiene of this stuff because you may get infected. Like I can use this syringe, which is mostly used by me, is fine. Your family member is fine, but of course if you borrow from somebody else, then of course you must be careful about the blood infection and all. So many different diseases. So you can buy the new one. But used one having no cost. Because you used to throw them, whereas I'm keeping it. And there in between connector you can have a tube, but this is actually throwaway pen, gel pen tube connected. So simple glued stuff, so effectively this is no cost. But putting water inside with bubble free, that's also a skill. Because once you'll fill up and once there will be bubble, then efficiency. Because air will compress than water and then it will not immediately respond to go other way up if you press from the other side. Anyway, so this is the con which I'll just leave on this end. And what do you expect? Okay, I'm not asking question, I'm telling you whatever you see. See, it's going to the higher side. So instead of going down, as everything goes down, it is going up. I need your, then whatever you have learned in science, that the gravity pulls everything down towards its center, is wrong. Let me know the answer. Right, I can show you another stuff, which is a simple toy, similar to that. So this is one physics, different experiment. So you see the structure of this, simple top, but in a different form. There is a ball, like there is no inside weight somewhere fixed out of center. It's not like that. Simple, but there is a cut and there is a spindle-like end. Fine. So generally, if I just leave this on the ground, it goes the spindle part up, whereas the toy goes like this. Can you just focus on this? Is it fine? Now I'll try to spin, though there is a clog on top of it, but I hope it will work. Let's see. Don't get. Oh, come on. That's fine. No way out there, it's fine. That's the only thing I was expecting. But need to have a little, so I have to spin. Oh, come on. You see that if I just spin this toy, then it is standing straight. So let me spin again. So is it again defying the gravity law? Defying, not defined, okay? So is it defying the gravity law? Thank you.